Hey everyone, Grant here for the Flame Learning Channel. In the Flame 2018.1 update, we'll run through the updated functionality with markers and segment markers in a clip or sequence. These redesigned tools will help you stay informed when working with a sequence, as well as carrying over a wealth of information when importing sequences from other editing applications. This video is not footage specific, so you can use your own media to follow along. Starting with the marker basics, here you have a single clip in the timeline view. To add a marker to the sequence, you place your positioner at the desired frame and press the backslash keyboard shortcut. This adds a marker across all the tracks and locks to the specific timecode in the sequence. When you select it, it will highlight and a line is drawn vertically in the sequence. Deselecting the marker removes the highlight and the vertical line. Now you can move the marker around, or delete it, either gesturally or through the contextual menu. In the effects toolbar, you can change the color, give it a name, as well as add additional comments in the second text box. If you were to alt-click on any marker, the info box will display the name and comment without having to select it. Now by default, the comment includes the username and time. This is all editable. What is useful to know is if you go into the preferences and go to the timeline tab, you can set the default text entries for the markers. We have also incorporated the ability to use naming tokens for dynamic information. Adjusting the marker defaults in the preferences is typically user-driven. However, you could also automate the marker defaults through a Python hook for a variety of situations, including software versions and project-based or facility-based scenarios. Now exit the preferences and go back to the sequence. The other type of marker you have is the segment marker. Hold Shift and press backslash. This time, the new marker attaches to this segment, and moving the segment around will take the segment marker with it. So you can put information relative to the sequence in a marker, or information relative to a segment in a segment marker. So if you're sending over a job or picking one up, you can put a lot of information into the markers to keep informed. So that is the marker and segment marker basics. Expanding on this further, it is possible to import XMLs or AAFs containing markers, and this information can be read by the Flame products. So switching to this sequence, here we have an edit that came from an AAF, and it contains a few markers and segment markers. Now when importing the sequences, markers will be used to carry any information explicitly pointed out in the offline. This now also includes the naming field to support naming metadata from an AAF. But markers will also be used to point out effects that were not translated as part of the conform. These markers and segment markers are typically pink, and their description will contain details of the effect. In addition to the pink markers, Flame will add an equivalent effect to help rebuild what was originally there. So conforming sequences with markers, or adding markers as you work, can certainly keep you well informed within the sequence. But as you add more markers and segment markers, you need an efficient way of navigating and managing them. To navigate from one marker to the next, press Ctrl backslash to navigate the markers forward, or Alt backslash to navigate the markers backwards. If you prefer to use the interface player controls, click and hold the Go to Next button and choose Marker in the pull-down menu. This will also update the Go to Previous button. Now that is just navigating the markers and not the segment markers. To navigate the segment markers, press Ctrl Shift backslash to navigate the segment markers forward, and Alt-Shift backslash to navigate the segment markers backwards. Similar to navigating markers using the interface, you can also switch the go-to buttons to navigate segment markers through the button pull-down menu. Now, what you have seen so far is a very quick but basic way of looking at markers in general, as well as navigating them in a linear fashion. To gain a much more holistic and detailed perspective of markers and segment markers, you can use the Markers view. Ensure you are looking at the standard player and click the Options pull-down menu. At the bottom of the list is Show Markers. This is mapped to the Alt-6 keyboard shortcut. So all the markers and segment markers are represented in this list, and all their details are on display for quick identification. You have the marker name, their frame or timecode location, the type of marker, marker or segment marker, color and comment. Finally, the parent and track columns are specific for segment markers. Now, the Markers view allows you to manage this data set in a variety of ways. So you can sort by various properties, as well as hide and reveal specific columns, etc. You can also edit the marker's name, comment, and color by simply clicking on the entry. You can also do bulk editing by making a multi-selection and then editing a marker property. But if you want to adjust the marker's positioning, you need to do that gesturally in the sequence. Now, marker selection is bidirectional. So if you select a marker in the sequence, it will highlight in the markers view and vice versa. The markers view can also be used for fast navigation. Just double-click on any entry to jump to that particular marker or segment marker. You could also right-click on any entry and jump to that marker. If you wish to delete a marker or multiple markers using the Markers view, just make your selection and use the options in the contextual menu. Now, in its default state, the Markers view shows all the markers and segment markers of the current sequence. At the bottom of the list, you can enable filtering and focus on something specific. This is not too different from the timeline search functionality. For example, enable filter, and you can choose between all markers, only segment markers, or only markers. You can also filter by color. And what's handy to know about the colors is that the pull-down menu will dynamically update with all the colors that are used in the current sequence. Finally, you can filter by a name or comment. As a great tip, if you type in a keyword, the filtering will search for that exact word. However, if you want to do a partial or wildcard search, just add an asterisk before or after the keyword to extend the filtering. Now, the markers and segment markers are great when you're working directly in the Flame products. However, sometimes you may need to send off a version to a client, and you would like them to be aware of what still needs to be done via marker names and comments. So in the next video, we'll look at burn-in metadata and how to add the marker information as a burn-in metadata layer. Be sure to check out the other updates to the Flame 2018.1 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.